Yes, sir. Welcome back, you guys, to another DBZRNYT video. And today, we're going to be talking about an idea that I've seen bouncing around from page to page or from community to community within Dogon regarding the trading system or a potential trading system or the incorporation of a trading system into Dogon. And I normally don't try and take the negative route, but I think a little bit of realism needs to be injected into this whole premise that trading could fix Dokkan or trading would be an amazing addition to Dokkan, which it possibly could be. But I think the realest possible outcome of this is that it's overall not what Dokkan needs. So what this video is about today is us pretty much not even listing everything that can go wrong, but pretty much explaining why a trade system isn't very possible within the realm of Dokkan. So without further ado, we can go ahead and get started. So my biggest reason that I don't think that a trading system would be able to be incorporated into Dokkan successfully is mostly due to the part that if there was a trading system incorporated, it'd be heavily dependent on the honesty and the integrity of the players of the community. And if you're a part of the Instagram, I'm not even going to say as much Twitter. I don't think it happens as much on Twitter. But if you're a part of the Dokkan community on Instagram, which I think is arguably just as big as the Dokkan community on Twitter, then you know there's some pretty toxic things that go on regarding scamming people for money, scamming people for accounts, botted accounts, this and that. For one, there's pretty much no possible way to monitor and accurately punish people who choose to scam, especially within Dokkan, because there's so many people. Like, let's say there was a way to trade units, right? Let's say I scammed you for a unit. Let's say we decided that we were gonna trade my STR Vegito for your physical Buhan, right? And right before the trade went through or something, I switched it to like an SR Piccolo from a banner, and then you ended up trading me your STR Vegito for a Piccolo. Like, things like that is what really scares me with this whole trading thing that everybody wants to happen, because I don't think that the community as a whole, this is not just on the Dokkan community, I don't think any community in its entirety on its own period can handle that much responsibility, because there's always going to be those people. And you know, everything sounds good and fine and dandy, and people are always like, well, that would never happen to me, until it does happen, and then that's when it's an issue, and then it's all take Dokkan trading out. And I just think that that would be a really big waste of time for them to spend all that time on an addition to the game that potentially ruins it, for one, and that they'll potentially have to take out of the game. It's just a huge waste of time. That's the time they could be using to create a different kind of game mode or something, or incorporate a different kind of PvP. You know, just overall, I think we can all see like the bigger picture that there's an underlying issue with this, and that is the integrity of the community, completely. On top of that, I mean, there's already people that have like botted accounts now and accounts that they use bots to farm certain things. Who's to say you don't, I don't know, have two separate devices, and then you go and you farm 3,000 stones and to rainbow, like, I don't know, like Jiren when he drops. Then you go on there, you rainbow Jiren, and then you trade that Jiren to yourself for like a rare unit. Like, dude, there's no way to monitor that. There's literally no way. And of course, like, I mean, they could see that you're doing that and see the account's inactive or whatever, maybe trace the IP address, but I mean, there's plenty of ways to get around that stuff. Like, we're dealing with the internet here. This is not just a regular community. Like, this is a community that's thriving through the internet. There's people, like, I know people can like pull addresses and stuff from people's Instagram accounts or from tweets. So I know there's ways around like the whole ban thing. And then we have everybody's account out there looking like truth, because everybody has a bot and everybody's training amazing units themselves, then I mean the game just wouldn't be fun anymore. I mean, everybody loses their diversity because that's the route that everybody chooses to take. So I just think overall the idea of trading, the sound of it is nice. The sound of being able, I mean, we all hate when we have units that we get, like me, I pulled 3 physical transforming Vegetas and I rainbowed him like 4 or 5 banners ago, dude. And it hurts me to see those Vegetas sitting in my box knowing that I have friends that don't have them. I have a brother that doesn't have them. Like, I know people who don't have Transformers Vegeta, they want them. Like, yeah, it'd be really, it's a really nice idea to be able to trade to them, but I don't think it's possible, and I think that's mainly due to the fact that our community is in a pretty bad shape regarding personal responsibility in things like trading. The Dokkan trade war right now is already terrible, and I get it that there's no, like, Bandai's not mediating that at all, but there's, you guys have to understand, there's really no way they can mediate it, even if they were to incorporate it themselves. And I'm pretty sure that was the part of the reason that they got rid of the transfer codes and stuff, was in an attempt to stop the trading, because, I mean, guys, Bandai isn't dumb. They know that there's a trading, like, market between Dokkan and stuff, and people buy accounts and stuff like that. But I'm pretty sure that's part of the reason they're trying to eliminate that. That's part of their, they want to eliminate that, and it's just, it's a toxic part of the community, and I don't think there's a place for it, at least not right now. Maybe there's some way that Bandai thinks of to you know, mediate this and it works. I don't know, who knows, but I just, from my perspective right now, I don't think it'll work. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Do you guys think that we can incorporate a trading system without there being much backlash or many consequences? Or do you think it's a terrible idea like I do? Leave a comment below. Just let me know. Make sure you like the video. Subscribe to me. Follow me on Instagram at DBZRNYT. And I'll talk to you guys later. Peace.